There were times when a basic Titan extruder with one small filament pushing gear was sufficient for our slow 3D printers, but now it just doesn't have enough gripping power to force the filament through the high flow hot ends, resulting in huge under extrusion and filament slip. And after I tested probably the most common BMG type extruder that uses small gears versus one that has big ones, I think the fate of small gear extruders will be quite similar and unavoidable like Titans. So let's find out more. As we all know, filaments are just plastics and they don't have the greatest mechanical properties. The most important one in this scenario is the material hardness level. We can easily deform plastics when higher forces are applied. To avoid that as much as possible, we have to increase the surface area of the material so that the forces would distribute along a bigger area, minimizing the deformation. This principle directly transfers to the 3D printer extruders. Going from one pushing gear to two doubles the surface area for the teeth to properly grip the filament, and going with larger gears even further widens the area as more teeth will be biting into the filament. So to test the theory in practice, I'll be comparing a BMG clone, Orbiter V2 and two extruders that Haldis 3D sent for this testing video. The HGX Lite is an older version with an aluminum frame and straight teeth. Meanwhile, the new version of it comes with angled teeth for even bigger gripping area and a lightweight and a smaller aluminum frame. The hot end for the testing will be the CHC Pro with CHT clone brass nozzle, and all the flow rate tests will be done by weighing the extruded amount of plastic, plus a few test prints for the comparison and close-up microscope shots to see what happens to the filament with higher forces. So first, let's start with the BMG type extruder. As it has a regular size NEMA 17 motor, power will not be an issue here. In all the graphs, you will see the last flow rate point when the stepper motor wasn't skipping steps. For these tests, I use a harder type of PLA filament, which is the most common one. So with the BMG, we get up to 20 cubic millimeters per second of somewhat consistent extrusion, and after that point, it goes downhill. Also cut some filament segments and force them at 40 cubic millimeters per second speeds to see how filament looks under the microscope. With a harder PLA variant, the embedded grooves looked not bad, but it was easy to see that they were not sufficient for these flow rates as the filament shows slipping deformation effects. But it was nothing compared to the softer PLA variant. Here the filament looks like a Christmas tree as it was deformed so much by the smaller gears. This could introduce all kinds of inconsistencies, so you don't want to see that entering your hot end. And to test the HGX Lite extruder, I had to design a custom bracket that the sponsor of this video, PCBWay, 3D printed from aluminum. I used the same principles as with the FDM plastic 3D printing, just with lower tolerances, and it worked beautifully. I also had to tap threads for the screws, and it was very similar to making them on a regular aluminum. Then I washed the bracket, spray painted and assembled the new printhead. Well then, does this big gear extruder make any difference? It actually did. Flow rates now look basically ideal. There will always be variance due to filament diameter consistency, stringing and some error in precision scale readings, but man, that line looks excellent. There was the same story with the filament deformation results. Harder type PLA looked great with very minimal dents compared to the BMG, but with a softer filament, this is where the true difference shows. It was like day and night, no cap. However, the true question is, does this directly transfer into the prints? The first one is my precision cube. I would say there was some difference if you would look closely, but not a huge one as we saw between two extruded filaments. Same with another test cube print. It looked more consistent overall on the layers, but it wasn't anything groundbreaking. I thought this one would have a way bigger difference as this was printed with softer PLA. But on this type of print, it is hard to reach max print speeds and the flow rate requirement is way lower. This leads us to another question, will with higher speeds and accels we'll see a bigger difference? Most likely, having a more precise filament control without deforming it never hurts, and Clipper's Precious Advance relies on that perfect control. The only issue is that in real world printing scenarios you don't want to be running a stepper motor at its max rated current. These NEMA 14 pancake steppers are most of the time rated for 1 amp per phase, meaning max 0.7 amp RMS. This is what Clipper uses when defining it, plus we should run it at around 80% of a max rating, so at 0.56 amps. And at that current we only able to achieve up to 24 cubic millimeters per second without the motor skipping a step. So we are limited by the stepper with these type of extruders. And you might think that something like the Orbiter V2 wouldn't have this issue as it has middle sized gears. But when I tested its flow rates, it kept more or less at the same max flow rate. This is because it has only 7.5 to 1 compared to 9.5 to 1 gearing ratio that these big gear extruders must have to compensate for the larger diameter gears. Plus, Orbiter's filament gripping results doesn't look that impressive too. This is where this new HGX extruder with big angled filament gears comes in. It had basically the same perfect extrusion consistency as the older version. The first time I saw these gears, I hoped so much for them, but it turns out we're limited by the stepper motor. So we couldn't see any difference that angle teeth with an even bigger gripping area could provide. The only one that I saw was that the short filament segments slightly spun when extruded. But turns out when you print from the spool, you won't see this effect as it has enough twisting resistance and it was sufficient to not turn this dual color filament print into a mixed mess. Also, the crazy part is that it is lighter than the lightweight champion itself despite being made from aluminum. The additional benefit of that is that it makes the frame act as a heatsink, helping dissipate heat from a stepper motor, allowing us to push it harder. So, there was a lot of info in this video. The most important thing for you to take from this is that if you are chasing every bit of quality in your prints, having an extruder with big filament gripping gears is beneficial. Most PLAs these days are the harder type and it helps for the small gear extruders a lot, but if we take into account over a variety of softer filaments, you want that bigger surface area to properly grip the filament and prevent the heavy deformation. So the big gears are the way. The only issue is that we are limited by the stepper motor's power. So you want to get one that has high torque and it doesn't plummet like a rock at higher speeds. And that is a hard task as not a lot of manufacturers provide that data. Hopefully this was informative and useful. If you liked the video, you know what to do. Thanks to everyone who watches and follows the channel and huge thanks to people on Patreon for their support. Well, that's all from me and we'll see you next time.